Hi guys, what's up you guys? It's your girl Yemi.com. Thank you for liking, subscribing, and overall vibing. Whoa. And just being here with me today. Today is, I want to say, what day is it? Let's find out. April 1st. For me, when I'm filming this. I'll edit it. Maybe it'll take me a week. Maybe 2 weeks. Who knows?
One eternity later.
But today's April 1st, which means that an artist has released a song and a documentary has been let out. Basically, this all came about, this idea for this video came about because Lucas has just released his new single, Renegade.
Look, I said they sleep, they don't sleep on me, I'm a whole beast. The whole scene in bed, this is my feast. I cooked time again, it's rookies, I swear I don't know what care where it feel like to be at the bottom.
And I've talked about this before on my channel about idols who were cast aside by their group, not their group, but their company. And cast aside is very heavy-handed. It's not always that, or left their group or were kicked out, whatever. And like the resurgence of that. And that's what I kind of want to talk about today. Because I've heard the song. You can say what you want. It's a fucking banger. I don't know what you take that with someone else. Song's a fucking banger. But like, there's this idea that's been going on, and it's been going on for a long time, but it's become more frequent, especially with social media and stuff like that, of idols making a comeback after they've left a group for, like, scandalous reasons of sorts. I have a list of idols. I'm gonna kind of walk through my thoughts on each of them, but also, like, my overall thoughts on like the situation of idols coming back and stuff like that when I get to the last person, I think. But first, I will need my handy dandy notebook. All right, okay, here we go, guys. There have been a lot of idols that have been removed from groups for various reasons, and they're also talented, but like troubled, but like it ranges from like absolutely heinous, disgusting behavior, Seungri from Big Bang, to bitch, what did I even do? Which is one of the people on the list from Momoland, I'll give you a hint. And I made a list of the ones who are still active, the ones who are currently still making music that I listen to at the very least, and I kind of wanted to go off that list and talk about each one. First up, we have where I think it really kind of popped off at, which as much as I hate this motherfucker, I don't hate him. And if you still don't speak, that means I don't fuck with you. Mr. J Park. We all know J Park used to be a part of 2PM, which was, is a man group, because you can't really call them a boy group, those are men, but a man group, obviously, and, you know, they're famous for almost never singing and always acting, but also taking their clothes off, because we love it. But, of course, J Park used to be, like, I think, was he the leader, maybe? Maybe he was the leader, the rapper, he got kicked out. I have a whole video about it. Not very loved because a lot of people love J Park, but I have a whole video about J Park. But he was in 2PM. He was basically essentially, I think, kicked out for comments that he made on MySpace when he was younger, during his trainee days, which like, as an American going through a trainee process in the early 2000s, like in the 2008, 2007, late 2000s era, I can understand like making those comments and like you're American, so you're like,
this is abuse.
But for Korea, it's like, no, this is your YN moment. This is your character building moment. So I could understand that. I think that a lot of the fans forgave him essentially. And I think that JYP was even like, oh yeah, like it's fine. And then like, I think the day that that happened, he was like, no, I'm out. I'm out. Y'all's too much. And then he went back to Seattle. And then obviously we know him as the solo artist that he is today. And the entrepreneur that he is today. And the mogul that he is today. Like, I can shit on him all I want for, like, all the stuff that he's done in correlation to black shit. that I don't like, but I can't say he's not a popular rapper, and he didn't pave the way for a lot of really good rappers. And he was one of the first people that I remember, like, actually get, like, I know him, Jessica, and then there was an instance where, what's his name, the big buff guy from California, he was almost kicked out of his group, but then he started crying, and all the fans were like, no, we love him. Him, yes. So, like, one of the first instances of, like, when I was rejoining K-pop and remembering what I used to listen to, of, like, oh, Jay Park was kicked out of 2PM, whoa, that's wild, but he's become a very popular solo artist. We all know that. We've all seen it. He's fostered a lot of talented people as we go the way. And I think he's one of the first big examples, other than like Jessica, of like leaving your group or being kicked out or leaving your group and like still thriving after and continuously thriving, no matter how much I sometimes hate it. You know what I mean? And you know what? He still takes his clothes off, just like when they were in 2PM. So really, is he really even gone? He's still naked. But that is like the first one I wanted to talk about. Like, cause it kind of like set the mold, pushed the boundary. Cause a lot of people like weren't doing it and he did it successfully. Now I'm gonna go to one that hurts my heart, which is Sujin from Idol. Sujin is like one of the weirdest cases, I think, for this, because she technically hasn't been proven innocent, but she hasn't been proven guilty, and she technically left, but the company treated her like crap, so it was like she kind of got kicked out. Even members of Idol who hate Yukui really like always talk about like how they hated how they treated her, how they're counting down their contract so they can get the fuck out of there, because like clearly they don't have any respect for them. I mean, obviously they respect them now because that's where they get all their money from, really, especially since Block B left. Like, that's where they get all their money from is Idol. But like, Sujin coming back is like kind of a breath of fresh air, because again, we don't know technically, legally, if she did it or not. We don't know because it's technically not solved, technically. But we do know that her company treated her like shit during the process, so it's kind of inconclusive. It was for a bullying scandal, which was like, that's one of the things I'll talk about at the end, but like, things came in waves. Like, there was a wave of scandals for one thing, a wave of scandals for the next thing, a wave of scandals for the next thing. So it really is something that I will talk about at towards the end. But she's doing great. She came back with a Gassi, I think. Which I was a GOT7 fan. I was like, that's a Gassi. And I don't think that's actually what it is. But she looks great. She's singing great. She's killing it. And I love that for her. And I just wish her the best, honestly. I believe flipping in the air. I never land, just float there. Next up, we have Chu from Luna. Never, another interesting case for me because it's like, it's clearly the company's fault. But it's weird because I think she had bullying allegations either before this or during this, I'm not sure. But the company stood by her and was like, suing, I guess, the people who were saying stuff about her, which is fine and great and dandy. But the second she had like an issue with how they were treating the staff, they turned it on at her and made it look like she was mistreating the staff, which we all know to be false, especially because we've seen what they've done to Luna and how disrespectful they've been. Blockberry Creative has never been one of my favorites. I think I talked about this in my Only One Of video. They're one of the ones that I just don't trust. There's a couple companies, Cube included, that I really don't trust with artists, and Blockberry Creative is absolutely one of them. She was talented, and I didn't watch Luna a lot, but I did love her and watch a lot of her fan cams specifically. Not to a solo stand degree, but I just liked to see her perform. So like to see her, that she's, you know, doing well and is touring a lot, which is really good because like you make a lot of your money from touring. So I'm very glad. I think she actually played at King's Theater, which is very close to me. I didn't get to go, but I was so excited to see her perform, or to see that she was performing. So I'm very glad for that one. She was literally innocent. Like, it was like, she went to court against Blockberry and won. Like, that's why it took her so long to come back out, because she had to do the court process, and then she was like, okay, I'm making a comeback. Ah, we love that. She has a beautiful voice, she's talented, and she collabed with one of my favorite artists who's also on this list, who I'll talk about next, with a song called Lullaby that is so pretty, and I love that song. That being said, that means we're going to our next person, who is the person who was also on that song, Mr. B.I. Hanbin, baby. Baby. I love this man. You can't tell me anything. Yes, keep me up, daddy. Yes, make my heart go beaty beaty. Like, when my eyes on you, so I care to touch on you. Oh, you know you get me loose, make me go bitter bitter. I dance on me for two, that he booted and told you. Oh, it's only me and you, make me go bitter bitter. Yes, I'll be your tangerine. Tangerine sky, knock a bomb sky. Oh, chung gun hug, and I'm one joke, you go. Like, I don't know, man. I just really love B.I. I love the vibe. Icon has always been a group, which is the group he was a part of, but then ended up leaving. Icon has always been a group that has been very talented in like hip hop, very rooted in that. And he was like one of the driving forces of that as a producer. Very talented, very beautiful, very effervescent, and we love him for that. However, I believe there was some issue with some drug allegations. And this is an instance of where he didn't get kicked out, but it was like distracting from the group. And he, I want to say he had so much respect for them that he was like, I'll just go, which is beautiful to think about in a sense. But also, you were the producer for most of their music, and their music has never been the same since. Like, they, like, he was the producer behind their, one of their biggest hits. So, in the end, because Icon actually really did kind of fall off after that, I'm not gonna lie to you. They weren't never like super in the forefront, but they absolutely fell off after B.I. left. And so like at the end, it's like, you did your best, but the, I feel like the company should have defended you better. And so that you would still be in the group and enhancing the group. Because the songs he's put out as a solo artist are some of the best bangers in KRMB. And like, people take him more seriously in KRMB because he's not in a K-pop group. So he's only flourished and thrived while I feel like Icon has stayed a little bit stagnant. That's my baby. You can't tell me my man. I love him. Every time I dream of a sequence where I have recurring dreams of S-Coups from 17, especially now he has that red hair and monster. Oh my god. Put your hands up! Put your hands up! I have been having reoccurring dreams of him, and it was always like we meet at a club, and the song we always dance to is BTBT by B.I. So that tells you something. That being said,
nigga, I need you to come to the U.S. I'm tired of this shit. I'm tired of like.
I saw BM's tour, and like, bless his heart, like, but I saw the B and the nether letter, and I was like, is B.I. coming? And it was BM, and like, not disappointed, but like, I was like, damn it. Anyways, the next person we're going to is Dawn. Dawn from Pentagon. If you don't know Dawn, he's most famous for being in Pentagon, and then, well, he is, well, I think his biggest song is Ping Pong with Hyuna, which is part of the problem. L-O-B-E, play the ping pong. I'm not talking about Hyuna because I don't, it's not my business, it's not my journey. Like, I liked Hyuna. She's not my queen, my idol, or my everything. So like, whatever decision she makes, that's on her. She's a grown woman. I, however, do love Dawn. I kind of listened to Pentagon, but I didn't listen to Pentagon before he left. He left and I was like, oh, I like his music now. There's nothing I can do for her. What did he do before? And then I listened to Pentagon. I was like, I kind of like this, but I like this more.
Mm-hmm.
his big thing was a dating scandal, which is so fucking trivial. I'm so sick and fucking... PSA announcement. I'm so fucking sick and tired of people having to leave groups, be castrated, make apologies for dating someone. Like, do you not like... I don't understand. Like, how would you... I just... It's like, in my mind, I'm like... How would you feel if your favorite idol, every time you, God forbid, struggle bust your way through this world and got a boyfriend or a girlfriend, and your favorite idol was like,
how dare you fucking betray me? I need you to write me a 20-page letter as to explain as to why you were fucking dating while you're supposed to be worshipping fucking me. How fucking dare you?
Imagine that. Imagine if your idols were as DeLulu inconsequential crazy as fans tend to be when they start dating. Like, I genuinely don't get it. Cause I'm like, this sounds vulgar and crass, but like, I want Suga to be getting ass. You know what I mean? Like, I want S Coops to get it thrown back on him. He deserves that at the very least. For all the struggles they've gone through, for all the green room basements, for all the strange buildings, for all the hate and the suffering. You think I don't want them to be having sex and like, that just makes no sense to me. Sex is a fun thing for people who enjoy it. And relationships are fostering and beautiful and can be great and beautiful. Why would you deprive someone you claim to love of that basic fundamental nature? Anyways, that whole rant was to say, I love Dawn. Dawn was in Pentagon and he also was in Triple H, which Hyuna was in. Together they met, fell in love, kissy kissy, mwah, mwah. And they were spotted out and then were swiftly kicked out of both Triple H, and Dawn was kicked out of Pentagon. They eventually went over to Psy's company and it became this whole, honestly, it was a fantastic PR move for Psy because everyone loved their relationship. Everyone thought it was genuine and honest. It was one of the rare times where people weren't like up in arms trying to burn these idols at the stake. So the fact that Psy came in and swooped them up and was like, don't worry, I'll take care of you guys, I believe in your love, and they like stayed together, they got engaged, like, and it was like a cute little kitchen, it was like a fairy tale. I mean, obviously they broke up and such ensues, but he's still making great music. He is phenomenal as an entertainer. Like, he's entertaining as hell to watch, and like, I would never have watched Pentagon if he did not leave Pentagon. So at the end of the day, he's still bringing the views to Pentagon from me. So that's all I gotta say about that. But yes, he was kicked out of two groups, not just one, but two. Next is another one we talked about, which I talked about and mentioned and referenced earlier. It's Daisy from MOMOland. She's one of the rare ones who I'm talking about on this list that's not necessarily making music anymore. She's a very, well, I follow her on TikTok, so that means she's famous to me, okay?
Excuse me, and I was like, oh yeah? And so she was like, I was thinking about this all day, but you really look like this person. And I was like, oh. So she flips her phone screen around and I'm looking at a photo of myself. So obviously I don't go around telling people, you know what? Actually, I used to blah, blah, blah. So I don't really talk about it. But at this point, like, I was looking at a literal photo of myself. I couldn't be like, oh my god, I kind of do look like her. So I was like, ha, that's really funny because that is a picture of me. Haha. So like, a few people were flabbergasted, but you know, it wasn't like that big of a deal.
I follow lots of people on TikTok who are technically not famous, but like, I follow her on TikTok, love her content, and she's so funny, goofy, silly. I use her clips a lot in my video because she's, again, funny, goofy, silly. She was in MOMOland, which was a disaster group that I'm a person who hates Survivor shows, like the island specifically, but like, what is it? The Produce 101 shows, I hate them because I was a fan of IOI And again, I took a brief absence from K-pop, so by the time I came back, they were already broken up. Same with 101, same with IZONE. It just breaks my heart because I thought X1 was the biggest fucking. Like, Flash by X1 was one of the songs that really did get me back into K-pop, other than BTS. So the fact that these groups were, like, all destined to break my heart anyways is fucking ridiculous. Momoland, I think, was similar to that, but it was all formed on a Survivor show, similarly. But I don't know if necessarily, because again, I never looked into Momoland other than, you know what I mean? And the only two members, three members I really know are Nancy, Joey, and Daisy. And Daisy was no longer in it. So Momoland is an interesting thing. Like, I think she jumped out of a moving car or was pushed out of a moving car that was headed towards a brick wall anyways. So she got out when she could. And, well, she didn't get out. They kicked her out. But
guys, for the love of God, I did not leave. I was fired. Okay, I don't know either. That's why I don't know. Like, if I knew, I would have probably unfired myself. So, I didn't know you can get fired from that. You know what? I didn't know either.
I like that she still has a thriving online career. I'm happy for her. She still doesn't know. I think she still doesn't know why she left. Or why she was kicked out. We don't know. And maybe it's because she was never meant to be a rapper. Roll the clip.
First of all, thank you so much for asking this, because I'm literally on my knees right now. I've been wanting to defend myself about this for forever. So get ready with me while I tell you the story of how I became a rapper and how it's all Nicki Minaj's fault. I have never once walked into an audition with a rap. Or not a single bar. But when you're a trainee, that's another word for being unemployed. And when you're unemployed, you're very desperate. And desperate times come for desperate measures. Like any good person would do, I was scouring my brain for anything that I knew how to do, like a little, like a secret talent of mine. And that took me back all the way to the year of 2010, which just so happened to be the year of the worldwide cultural phenomenon of tweens all over the world memorizing Nicki Minaj's Super Bass word for word, as if it was gonna be on the SATs. So I gave them a little, this one is to the boys of the boomer system. And these clueless 40-year-olds were absolutely blown away. And from that day on, I was a rapper. And this is why it's so funny for me whenever I get like a comment saying like, oh my God, I loved your, or like, you're such a good rapper or whatever. I'm like, I laugh at the comments so hard because what are you talking about? Did you listen to my part on mute? Like, I will admit, as horrible as it was a little silly. So how much money did I make as an idol? During the course of the 2 years, I was paid once. And don't freak out yet because it's because of the enormous amount of debt I was in. And if we look at the amount of this one-time payment, my translating job made 1.3 times more than when I was an idol. So I actually never did this math until today, and I was really upset. So you might be thinking, Daisy, I think you got scammed. But I was only paid so little because I had a ginormous amount of debt. It was around $150,000 in debt. So I paid off that $150,000 and then got my one-time payment that was less than my translating job. Are you guys following? Because I know it's a lot. So anyways, with that money, I prepared for college. Some people work at their local fast food chain to pay for college. I worked at Inkigayo. We are the same. A big fat disclaimer before I go and do my lashes, because some of us are not very bright. I don't know how much everyone makes. This is about me. Hopefully people are making more. All I'm saying is think twice before becoming an idol, because you honestly might be better off flipping burgers at Wendy's. So that's all for today.
Next up is 1-0. Yes, our big beefy man. I think he's currently in the military. serving, even though he's served all his life. That's the running joke, because all of our favorite idols are going to war, except for S-Coups. Anyways, Wonu, talented to boot, very big and broad, like very hot, and it's the Changbin effect. Like, if Changbin was to have a father, it would be Wonu. Like, it's just, you're brolic as fuck, but you still shake ass. Like, how is it that your body moves when you have so little range of movement? Like, I've seen The Rock and John Cena just struggle bust their way down the red carpet, and yet you guys pull out full choreo and eat that shit down. So I love Wonu. I love him. He was in, I don't know if I said what the other people were in, but he was in Monsta X, who I still love. I think I just put out a video about one member of Monsta X being a child of SHINee. I love him in Monsta X. I wasn't a big Monsta X like fan until very recently, and again it was like the Youngji interview, and then him and Hyungwon and Jungwon doing shit. I was like, okay, blah, 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 blah. Like, I've heard Monsta X, blah, 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 blah. I heard that, blah, 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 whatever. But Wonu was in Monsta X. He left because of, I think it was marijuana allegations. Yes, drug and marijuana allegations. He voluntarily left because, again, a lot of these people, I feel like when they voluntarily leave, it's either their company is pressuring them to leave, or they're looking at their members, they're caring about their members, and they're like, this is ruining their lives, I gotta go. And I feel like, you know, B.I., I feel like that was one of the situations. It's the only one I've really mentioned so far. I think that they were like, kind of like, I gotta go. So he was kind of like, I gotta go for the group. There's been like discourse, I feel like, a little bit, but I think for the most part, everyone is happy that he's fine and happy, and he was proven innocent, and we love him. He dances, he sings, he's beautiful, he moves like a dream, he's brolic as fuck. We love him. Come back safe, baby. Okay, that's just one of the ones I wanted to mention, just because I love him. Next up is one of the tragicest stories, I think, in this book, and I'm glad she had kind of a redemption arc on this TV show that I will talk about a little bit when I mention her a little bit. It's Jimin from AOA. I was a big K-drama fan, so one of the K-dramas that I ended up watching was called Revenge Note, I believe. It was starring Chanwoo, which is how I got into Astro. I watched Revenge Note, found out about, or I watched some kind of drama where he was feeding people, Chanwoo, I don't know why. Then I was like, who is this beautiful motherfucker?
초반에 나왔을 때보다 더 잘생겨지고 있는 것 같은 느낌 들어가지고 사람이 맞나 싶을 정도로 좀 놀래서 본인도 그렇게 생각합니까? 어리석은 질문이긴 합니다만. 뭐라 대답해야 될지 솔직하게. 네?
I know this has nothing to do with Jimin, but I'm getting there. So then I watched him in Revenge Note, and I was like, oh my god, who is this girl group? Like, AOA.
얘들아, 우리 위남이 잘 챙겨줘. 나한테 아주 소중한 팬이거든.
Who has this cutesy little song going on? Bam, 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 bam. Love that for them. It all fell to shit. If you don't know, this is one of the most talked about topics in K-pop history, scandal history. It was messy for like a year and a half. It was crazy. There was back and forth. There was lots of suicide stuff. It was very disgusting and messy. If you want to hear about the full thing in detail, I will link down a Stephanie Su video. Love her. And she covers and talks about the messiness that was within AOA and Jimin's backlash. This bitch was hated by a nation.
for the next 8 hours after these posts went up, feeding frenzy. It was like blood in the waters and netizens were sharks. They descended on Jimin with passion, hatred, disgust, and you know, this is me coming from hindsight. It's kind of sad when you think about it, because these netizens don't have proof that Jimin is a bully, but they're so upset with her that they're bullying her now.
Everyone was on Mina's side. If you don't know, again, go down, watch the video, come back. Everyone was on Mina's side. Everyone was like, Mina didn't do anything. Why would they do this? Jimin is bullying. They were putting compilation clips of this bitch, like just doing regular idol shit and being like, look at how evil she is. But you know what? Everyone was like taking those clips out of context and being like, look at her. F***ing evil. We all knew it. Look what she did to Mina. Then Mina started to unravel online, which is often the downfall of powerful women who like to accuse people of shit. Nicki Minaj. They just start to unravel online and it becomes their fucking downfall. And that's exactly what happened. And Jimin started to get cleared. Like, she really just like left the group for the, she's another one who like left the group for the good of the group. She was like,
this is mentally taking a toll on me. I can't, she was the leader too. She's like, I can't properly lead you guys. I can't even understand how to fix whatever's going on with her. Everyone just thinks I'm the demon and I don't want that on us. So I'm gonna leave.
The transcripts read a little bit gaslighty. If I say so myself. And Jimin was like, oh my god, well, I must have done it then. And she was very, very apologetic. She didn't try to argue and say, well, I don't remember, so it never happened. She kept apologizing. She was sobbing most of the time. She said she was going to quit AOA, quit the industry. She wanted to do anything to make it better for Mina. She was really begging. She said that all she wanted to do was be a good leader, but clearly she failed. And this isn't her trying to be like, I did this for you. She seemed super, super remorseful. She kept repeating, it's my fault, it's my fault. I never meant to hurt your feelings. I just wanted us to be the best versions of ourselves. Like, I didn't realize that I was hurting you. I never meant to make you feel this way.
Which again, she was kind of the linchpin of the group. So the group fell apart quickly right after her. She recently made a comeback. Recently, like last year, she was on a TV show with Mimi, who she ate that shit up. Moonbyul, who she ate that shit up. Moonsua, who she ate that shit up. And of course, Jimin from AOA. She had a very emotional comeback. It was very beautiful and stunning. It reminds me of the, what is it? Diao performance from this Chinese singer who had a comeback after her mom stole all her money. Another Stephanie Su video reference. But it was very beautiful, very emotional, very tearful, and she was very talented. And I hope baby girl continues on that journey, because she did not deserve the hate that a nation gave her. A full fucking nation. And the wild thing is that, like, it wasn't just Korea. I think everyone really, like, hated her. I was like, I don't know these bitches. I'm staying out of it. She seemed sweet. I kind of liked her, but I'm staying out of it. But a nation literally, like, turned their pitchforks and firearms at her. And it was like a Blair Witch Project, Salem Witch Trial hunt for this bitch. She is a beautiful singer. Again, her crime was bullying a member. She was proven innocent, obviously, because Mina started to unfucking hinge. No fucking, like, disrespect to Mina, because obviously, get the help you need, baby girl. You ruined a whole group, but, like, get the help you need still. Next up, as we're rounding out our... This is a list of 11 people, but as we're rounding out, we have Woojin from Stray Kids. Okay. was an interesting topic, baby. I don't know any other group that hates a member who left to protect his members, kind of, or was kicked out. Like, I don't know any other group that hates another member that much. Sunri from Big Bang sexually assaulted and conducted a ring of rape and porn and torture and a systematic thing, and people who are Big Bang fans are still like, we love him. He gave us fantastic baby bitches. Y'all need to put some respect on his name.
Oh my God, corny, lame, boo, tomato, I'm throwing tomatoes.
Let's seek employment. I know you can't because you're in jail, but like, let's find a hobby, let's find God. They have a prison counselor, I'm assuming. Let's do literally anything else but this. Bueno? Pinyu! Bueno? Pinyu!
Bueno? Pinyu! Woojin literally got falsely accused of sexual assault, and then everyone hated his ass. He left the group because it was making too much noise for his group members. Left, kicked out, whatever, again, the pressure, whatever. And every stay, like, not every stay, but a lot of stays are still like,
yeah, fuck that nigga.
And I'm like, he's proven, he's had a two-part documentary to prove that he did not do the shit. Like, are you crazy? What? And going back to what we were talking about before, he's still putting out great music. Gotta live it up, breaking all the stress. Then the third day, I'm getting okay. You get another kiss. That's all I got it. No, I'm a pretty mess. That name was even not a cat. You don't want to. I know I'm a pretty mess. I don't know. No, no, no. Don't. That he still struggles with it because, like, people still hate him for something he did not do. And a lot of people will, like, reference a lot of Stray Kids videos saying, like, you know, Stray Kids is 8 or whatever. Like, they say that because, of course, they fucking have to. They're not gonna be like, yeah, Stray Kids is 9, but, like, one of us is fucking gone, bro. Like, they're not gonna say that. And people, like, will reference and take small things from V-Lives and be like, yeah, they fucking hated Woojin. And it's like, they did. It doesn't feel like that's a group of boys where I'm like, I don't think, maybe Hyunjin, but I don't think any of them, maybe Ayan, I don't think any of them have a hateful bone in their body. Like, I don't think that poor baby Felix, look at his little face, look at his little fashion model face, is like, I hate Woojin and I'm glad that motherfucker's gone. Like, I don't get that energy from them. Again, I've only been to one Stray Kids concert. I'm not even a huge stay. Like, I'm not even calling myself a stay. Like, I don't, like, keep up super, super a lot. So I don't know. Correct me if I'm wrong. I always love to be corrected in the comments. But, like, it really did feel like that for a long time. And it was very strange and sad to see. 마음에 불어오는 시린 바람 지나 돌아보게 돼. 몇 년이란 시간이 짧은 것 같아. I need only one. 행복한 너의 기억들. Of course, again, he released his documentary talking about it. His company released a two-part documentary. Lots of people have, like, released documentaries or video series talking about, like, how this is kind of fucked up and he didn't do anything wrong, but, like, some people just really love to ignore that shit. Speaking of documentaries and things that got released, we're talking about Lucas, who is the number 10 of this list. There's a number 11, but that leads into, like, the final countdown of this all. But number 10 of this list is obviously NCT's Lucas.
Baby, summer lasts forever. I'm crushing on you. Think I fell in love with the summertime, girl. Summertime, yes, it's the summertime, yeah. Baby, 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 make me roll with the go, with the flow, with the summertime, girl. I'm crushing on you.
Lucas was, he's the only one on the list I think is like guilty as fuck. It's like that meme from the Kevin video where he's like, I did that shit.
And I did that
Wow. Wow.
Okay.
He's him.
I'm kind of turned on.
He's him.
Yeah.
Hey, yo.
His crime was like sexual deviance, I want to say. I wrap it up by writing sexual deviance, but it's like gaslighting, cheating, like being an overall dick to your girlfriends, like having sex with fans, which is like a big no-no. Unless S-Coops or Sugar, I mean, I don't know what you're doing. But anyways, sorry, back to what I was supposed to be talking about. Or B.I. Sorry, okay, back on topic. He, I feel like, is the only one I'm like, oh, he did that shit. Yeah, he did that shit. But it was not a crime. Like, I think a lot of people who hate him are strong feminists, which I'm like, what are you doing in K-pop? Because this is like not the place for strong feminism, hello.
In South Korea, you could be a woman reading a book that feels a little bit feministy, and people will be like, burn her at the fucking stake. How dare she want to be treated like a human being? Women are just over it, to put it nicely. They're not getting married. They're not having children. And I just want to point out, women do not exist for men, and men would not exist without women. So let's just all be nicer to one another, you know?
But they're either really strong feminists or they're huge NCT Wavy fans. And he fucked up a whole comeback off this shit. So like Wavy, I think, went on like hiatus for like months or whatever, or years even. So he fucked up a whole comeback for them. Or just like, I don't know, young. Because
I think another reason why people are so frustrated is that you can't help but draw comparisons between Lucas's situation and then Sunghan from Rise, I guess. So it's like SM is giving Lucas his own solo debut while simultaneously Sunghan from Rise is being punished for less. And you know what I say to this? I'm pitching this directly to camera, directly to SM. Hey, just give us Sunghan back, and I think we'll all chill out about Lucas. But seriously, if you bring Sunghan back into Rise, I will start to listen to their music. I will start to stand, I promise. But you have to bring him back. Give him back.
This is not to denigrate what these women suffered through, because the Lord knows I would fucking slash his throat if he did any of that shit to me. I don't think that Lucas is a good person. Did you put it out there? I don't think that nigga's a good person.
Because hot people are horrible.
But like, do I think that Offset from Migos is a good person? No. Do I still fucking bang to Motorsport? Fucking yes. Like, there's a line for me of like illegal, you did some illegal shit that actually like killed some motherfuckers, that actually like ruined fucking lives, and that you could go to jail for. Yes, I am talking about that motherfucker, Chris Wu. And then there's some shit that's like, literally you're doing the same thing that many other artists who are also not in K-pop or are in K-pop are doing. I think it comes back to this point that I'll make at the end, but it got bigger than it necessarily would have because of the waves of like scandals that I was talking about. There was a wave of dating scandal, there's a wave of so-and-so, and he got caught up in the wave of like sexual scandals, because like those are two different crimes. One's a crime and one is not. One's a dick move, one's a crime. Two different things. So I do understand why people are upset with him. I understand if you never want to listen to his music again. I just don't understand why A, he's still with SM, which whatever, or and B, like, just the strangeness of it all. I think it's very strange. He's the only one on this where I'm like, yeah, you're fucking guilty, but like, that's not gonna stop me from playing your music. I won't be buying albums, I'm not going to the concert, like, I'm not doing that shit, but like, Renegade is kind of a banger. See in the face, I see in the eyes that by tell lie. So I'm gonna dance to it a little bit, like, what do you want me to do? Like, if it comes up on my playlist, what the fuck do you want me to do? So, and that's gonna get me a lot of shit, like, obviously. Like, I'm a woman. Like, I get these things, like, from what I've read up, because I've tried to read up as much as possible, I understand and get why people are mad. I'm just saying why I will still be listening to specifically Renegade. I don't even know if I'm gonna go through the whole album, if there is an album, but I will say Renegade popped up and I was like, okay, kinda like the song. He wasn't kicked out, he kinda left after a really long hiatus. And then he's still on SM. He's one of the few who are like still on the label, like a subsidiary of the label. I like Lucas, again, not as a human, but as an idol. Because, like, literally the only people from... I don't listen to NCT. I don't know if you could tell by the way I was talking. But the only people I know from NCT is, like, Mark, Ten, Lucas, obviously. Mark, Ten, Yang Yang. And I'm sure I know more when they, like, pop up on my dance, on my screen, and they do a little dancey dance. Like, I'm a girl who's, like, I'm a casual listener of NCT. There's too many things going on for me. I hate storylines as it is. It's the one thing that, like, will always keep me from making ATs my, like, one of my old groups, is because their storylines are so confusing for me. So fucking confusing. I get distracted by, like, too much stuff. And NCT is just an excess of everything. But I will casually go two baddies, one Porsche. Or if I'm wearing puffy pants, go baggy, 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 baggy jeans. You know what I mean? So I don't have any dog in this fight again. So like, if you're a big NCT fan, please leave your perspective down below, because I would love to know it. I don't have a dog in this fight. So like, I'm just like, he's just doing his job, and he's no worse than any of the American rappers I listen to. Offset habitually cheats on his wife, who is one of my favorite female rappers. Jay-Z cheated on Beyoncé. Okay? Like,
we're not gonna forget about it, but we're gonna forgive, because I cannot keep on living with all this rage inside of me.
All these men, all these rappers, especially in hip-hop, can you name me one other than, like, I don't know, maybe, like, Kendrick Lamar, because he's, like, a cut above the rest. Maybe Logic, just because he was so whipped on his wife for so long. Who didn't cheat on his wife or girlfriend? Like, literally, like, hip-hop is all about that. Have a baby by me, baby, be a millionaire. Like, he just lived a life a little too accurately in a country that doesn't like that shit. So, and also the whole fan thing. I think, like, taking advantage of people who buy your albums is really fucked. Period. And that's kind of the 10. And the last one I'm gonna mention is kind of the wrap-up point of, like, what I wanted to talk about when making this video. And that is Miss Kim Garam. What you looking at? 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 I'm fearless, huh? I've talked about her 1,000 times in a lot of videos. I made a Blackpink video where I was mentioning which people should take over which people. I think I put Garam as like Jenny, they should take over, whatever. I love her. I loved her. She never was my favorite, let's be real. It was always Yoonjin. It was always Jennifer. From the day I accidentally stumbled upon those little intro videos before Fearless came out, it was Jennifer. I love Jennifer. She's still my bias to this day. Love that bitch. New York. Albany or wherever she's from. Anyways, Garam was the youngest member, one of the youngest members of LeSserafim. She had the bullying allegations were proven false, but before she could finally prove them false, she left or was kicked out of LeSserafim. Why I'm mentioning her last as opposed to Lucas, who was the inception of this video, is because she hasn't made a comeback. She's like, I think in college or something. She's graduated, she's going to drama school, whatever. I want her to make a comeback. I personally think that she would make a great actress. I think that I want to see her in dramas. I think that I've been deprived of that because of whatever bitch ass hoe accused her. And I feel like they either need to pay me reparations or they need to put her in a drama. I will not stand for this. Those are the only two options I want. I either want her in a drama, preferably starring Chan Woo, or that person who accused her needs to pay me specifically reparations, because she was so talented. She had her dreams crushed at such a young age for something she didn't fucking do. And that's a lot of people in the industry. These are just people who've made their comeback, other than Garam, obviously. And yeah, so that's kind of the reason I want her back. That being said, this is the wrap-up area. This is where we're going to talk about why I even made this list, why I wanted to talk about it at all, is because this is a new resurgence. Like, a lot of the names that I mentioned are recent. Like, they made a comeback within the last, like, they're post-pandemic comebacks, most of these people. Like, there's a few, like, I think B.I. or Wonho, who were, like, before the pandemic. But, like, most of these people, like Suju and Chu, like, they're coming back now, post-pandemic. And I feel like it has a lot to do with social media outrage, with people being more informed and being able to be more informed, and with the spread of it. With Korea, everything is so congealed in this area that there's a lot of, like, you can just get into a mindset of, like, this is the normal. And it's only, a lot of the times, it's only when people from outside are like, no, that's fucking not. That's weird as fuck, dude. That person, just weird as fuck. It's the UIN situation all over again, where it's like,
dude, that's what I think is so crazy. There are people in Korea right now that are so mad at UIN for getting caught for drug usage that they're throwing coffee at him. Which is unhinged.
Like, drugs are like, yeah, they hurt people, but like, they don't hurt people. Meanwhile, Sungri is like able to escape to the military and just like do whatever the fuck he wants. And like, now he's out turning it up in the clubs. Like, you know what I mean? Like, you need to sort out your priorities, Ron Weasley style. Regardless, with all that being said, I just wanted to mention this because I'm glad that this resurgence of, you know, K-pop stars who have been kicked out or removed from their groups and coming back as soloists specifically, like, is happening. I think it should happen more. I feel like a lot of people whose careers got unjustly cut, like, don't get that chance again, and they just live sad lives, and that's, or they live happy lives, I don't know, just not famous ones. But I feel like the chance to get your dream back is something that is so precious, especially when you spent all that time working towards it and you fought the odds and became someone who actually fucking debuted, and all of a sudden a random word from a random person who is fucking lying on you is crazy to me. So I'm glad that they're getting their stripes back, and that's all I really wanted to say with this video. Another thing that I teased but didn't completely mention is the waves of cancellations. So a lot of the times, whatever the wave is how you'll be canceled. There was a wave of relationship cancellations, especially when Hyuna and Idan like came out as a couple. It was also during that wave. That one is always kind of lingering in the background, especially with Dispatch loving to out couples at the beginning of the year. But then there's other kinds of waves. There's the bullying wave that affected people like Chu from Luna and Sujin, of course, and even Hyungjin from Stray Kids, I think, had allegations, and Mingi from Seventeen because of the wave. Then there was the wave of sexual deviancy that happened. Of course, we know the most famous one is Lucas, but there was also Woojin. There was also, like, different things. So with every year, there's a different wave of cancellation and just what rotates in. And by wave of cancellation, I mean wave of cancellation and accusations. As we know, they're not all true. And I'm glad to see that people are able to get their careers back. With that being said, I'm Yummy.com. Thank you for watching, internet friends. Don't worry, I'll be back, so stay tuned.